Everyone always talks about mining Bitcoin and just like mining on the computer and getting free money just out of thin air. Well, have you actually tried it? It's not as easy as you think. Today in this video, guys, we're going to talk about Lumerin. Lumerin can be purchased on KuCoin Exchange. There will be a link in the description below where you guys can get 20% off your trading fees. But let me go and explain to you guys what Lumerin is and what problems it is looking to solve. Let's go back to our example of mining Bitcoin. If you try mining on your laptop, boy, you better not be trying to surf that internet, because that 2 cents worth of Bitcoin you'd be mining for? Nah, bro. Your computer ain't gonna let you do nothing. That thing's gonna be whizzing and whirring in order to get that 2 cent worth of Bitcoin while you can't do nothing sitting there twiddling your thumbs. You're competing against some serious big rigs. You want to take a look at some? So now that you guys see your competition, now I think you're seeing the problem. So let's explain a little more how Bitcoin mining works. When blocks are mined, there's only one winner. So it's your small PC or little tiny computer versus these warehouses of things. Like, we're talking like miles of these factories. It's crazy. These guys are just going nuts and ham mining these jokers out. So solution number one to this problem, since it's your one little PC versus all these miners for this tiny little one block reward, was to create mining pools to where my computer with their computer with a bunch of other people's computers all get together into one pool to go after that one block reward, and it's split between everyone. But now you're starting to see, oh, wait, that's a great solution, but there might be a problem. It's trust. How can you trust the owner of that mining pool is going to make sure everyone is paid out evenly? And that's a problem. It has trust issues, stability, and hash power probability. Because I may be mining one day, but the next day, Johnny Freddy over there, he's like, nah, bro, I give up. I'm tired of getting my 2 pennies. I'm pulling the plug. So he pulls the plug. Everyone's hash rate goes down. How can you predict that? Well, you can't. So this is where Lumerin comes in. Lumerin is a routing protocol that makes it simple and easy to control how and when and why data and communication are routed via smart contracts. So this is basically smart. So of course, this little mining Bitcoin thing is not the only thing it does. This is the very first proof of concept for Lumerin. Now here's a couple of other use cases. First, using Lumerin to buy, sell, and trade data as a commodity. Another is using NFTs as communication rules for a node on your phone. Monetize encrypted peer-to-peer video and music streams through smart contracts. Or even in this simple example of using the Lumerin Hashpower Marketplace. Lots of cool stuff you guys can actually do with this token. For those who are not really understanding the full mining setup, that's okay. Let's go ahead and give you a real world example. Let's take an apartment complex, for example. Who owns the actual apartment complex? Well, it's actually the homeowners association. They own the entire apartment complex. However, you can own a tiny little apartment inside the apartment complex. So this would kind of be the example of Lumerin. Like, the apartments would be the different, I guess you can say, computers that are mining Bitcoin. And then the HOA, which is the whole Lumerin network, coordinates and combines the whole operation together. Keep in mind, for a network like this to work, market participants must believe that the hash power that they're buying and selling through Lumerin is authentic. So how can we address this concern? Well, Lumerin provides mathematical proof of existence of the hash power in a decentralized and trustless way. How do they do this? Well, one is hash rate oracles, 2, staked hash rate validators, 3, staked TCP proxy nodes. So let's go ahead and break down a couple of these. So we're going to go ahead and break down the flow. In the first stage, oracles prove the existence of the hash rate. So great, we are able to prove our hash rate. So now we can figure out the buyers and the sellers, etc. Stage 2 involves transferring the job of validating the hash rate from a centralized oracle to a designated group of validators. So at this point, we are distributing the hash rate and the power between the community. Their job will be proving hashing difficulty for each accepted pool share and submitting the proof of work done to the smart contract. So that is the second step. Third is validators will get a small fee from each hashing contract they monitor as a payment for their services. Those that fail to complete the tasks or those that decide to become bad actors will lose their staked bounty, which is Lumerin. So Lumerin is your utility token. It's going to be staked. It's used as payments for this ecosystem. And lastly, this involves each node broadcasting the hashing work to the rest of the Lumerin network. So this step allows the nodes to verify shares submitted by one another. So this is the very last step. This submits it and broadcasts it through the whole chain. And then we have consensus. So again, to sum it up, the Lumerin token will be the transactional token of the Lumerin protocol. Initially, we will have a Hashpower marketplace for the Bitcoin mining rigs that are sold and purchased denominated in LMR, which is the token. Gas and fees on the protocol will also be denominated in Lumerin. So I think it really helps to break down the model and what's happening. So in this photo right here, you have the mining facility bringing their work, quote unquote work, into the hashing oracle. And the hashing oracle is going to validate and be able to say, okay, look, this is good. This is verified. Let's go ahead and broadcast it. And that's where Lumerin comes into place, where they verify that the mining facility actually provided those services of mining through their mining facility. And they're able to say, okay, look, they did this much work. We're going to go ahead and say, all right, this is good. They're solid. They did what they're supposed to do. This is what it is. And it broadcasts to the network. So now that that work was broadcast to the network, now we need to validate how much is being mined, how much work they're doing, and whatnot. So this is where each individual Lumerin node will come into play. And once they get their information, this will be passed along to the customers looking to purchase this hash rate work power. So the miners are the sellers, and the purchasers will be like mining pools or other customers looking to buy the hash rate power. So here's a little bit of the flow as well. As you can see here, you have the mining device. So this is the person giving out the shares, which goes into the Lumerin node, which is then distributed to the network. And these guys are all verifying, saying, yeah, they're hashing this, this, and this. They're doing this right. Good job. And they broadcast back to the network and say, yes, they did this, this, and this. So then it goes to the mining pool saying, hey, look, we validated that they were doing 1 terahash of work. So 1 terahash of work is worth $50. This is just a theoretical example. So then you can see that Denise will have to pay out $50. As you can see, the accepted shares, they pay out, which is paid to these node validators. And then also the shares are given to the mining device because they're paid for their work as well. And then Denise profits with the Bitcoin because in this case or scenario, she bought hashing power, which was mining Bitcoin. So this is the flow you guys can see in the white paper. So if you guys want to take a look into the white paper as well as the Lumerin website, you guys can learn more details on what's up on here. So as you guys can see here, they do have a couple of strategic partners. They got Titan, Coinbase Ventures, which is a big one. Hive Blockchain, which is sauce, man. These guys are a Bitcoin mining company. So I'm sure they'd love this type of protocol to sell out some of their mining services. You also have Fembisha Capital, you have Bitdeer, you have DFG, you have Borderless Capital, Tribe Capital, Block. So a lot of different Bitcoin and cryptocurrency related companies and some major VCs. So I really do think this is a unique approach that Lumerin is taking. Lumerin is building a decentralized protocol that enables people to exchange, reroute, and redirect hash rate in this example, effectively. This is not the only use case. It's also able to control how, when, and why data is communicated through these smart contracts. So there's many other use cases for this token in general. If you guys would like to purchase this token, it is on KuCoin. There's a link in the description below. There will be a link, a referral link you guys can use. It'll get you guys 20% off for your trading fees. And guys, this is not financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor. I'm just explaining to you what Lumerin is. This is not advice for purchasing the token or trading with the token. Thanks for tuning in, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. We'll see you guys in the next one.